Hello, Descent fans, I guess. I mean, this is not exactly Descent. I'm sorry for anyone who came into the stream thinking it was Descent. Sol Contingency is not actually in the Twitch or Hitbox game list, so I had to go with Descent. I'm sorry, it's the closest thing that's there. But yeah, this is Sol Contingency, the upcoming game by... Actually, not quite sure who, but basically there was a... Anyway, there was a remake of Descent that was being worked on some time ago, and the people working on it ended up getting a cease and desist, and they ended up remaking it as Sol Contingency. So this is basically Descent, or what the closest that exists right now as far as Descent goes. I haven't actually played it in a while, but like Descent that is, at all, but I'm super excited to get into the closed beta, and I'm also doing terrible here. I have not had a chance to actually play against people. I also want to do some testing and see if tri-chording still works as a thing, but I'm not sure what I can do that safely. If I move forward, 1, 2, 3, okay. Now if I move, yes. All right. Ah. One sec. So for those of you not familiar, I'm just testing one thing. 1, 2, 3. Oh, it's a bit faster. And if I bank slightly, 1, 2. Oh! Holy crap, I think they actually kept tri-chording in. I'll explain in a sec once I die. So anyway, what I was testing right there, I'm not entirely sure, I'd have to do some more tests, but basically in early Descent games, they didn't, pretty much any early shooter before I think Quake-ish, they didn't normalize your direction. So if you ended up moving, say, forward and to the right, it would add forward and to the right into one vector that was 1.4 times the maximum speed. Like, root 2 times the maximum speed. For those of you who study your Pythagoras, you know why that is. In Descent, that was also the case. Except it was 3, not 2 directions. So you could go up to root 3 times your speed, which is about 1.7 times. Damn, I'm doing terrible. And this meant that you could go... You could go remarkably fast just because you were going off at an angle. I wasn't expecting tri-chording to work, and I still need to test it because Unreal Engine 3, which is what this is built on, that uses normalized movement vectors. Like, you're supposed to be moving in a unit sphere, not a unit cube. But I think they might have recreated the old Descent flight model of essentially flying in a unit cube rather than a unit sphere. Which is interesting, but bears further testing. However, at this point, it seems like tri-chording may exist. Yeah, it looks like it does. It feels like I'm going faster, but I'd have to check, because it's hard to say. I need a timer. Like, it feels like it, but at the same time, it also feels faster when you're moving towards something while looking at a wall. If I were to move... Sorry, I realize it might be a bit boring, but... 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Yeah, that's faster. That is actually faster. Okay, so good to know. Tri-chording is actually worth doing. I don't know if afterburner pulsing is worth doing, but... Well, that part of the flight model is confirmed. Now let's find someone to actually get my revenge on, because I'm getting annoyed by not having any kills on the board. Let's get on the board. I don't really like the Vulcan cannon very much, or I guess Gatling as it's called in this game. But it seems to work okay. I wonder if I should keep... Okay, so right now, in case you're wondering, I'm actually using a keyboard gamepad combination. I don't have a proper joystick, so I'm holding the gamepad in my right hand and using the right stick to move and the buttons to fire with my keyboard for motion. Mouse movement is basically a virtual joystick. That's kind of the bad news. Like, the good news is that Descent's flight model apparently is perfectly intact. The bad news is that it's, well, I guess bad-ish, okay-ish. Not to be too unexpected news, joysticks work better. I don't have a proper joystick, though. The best I have is a gamepad. And since tri-chording is a thing, which I wasn't sure about it... Oh, shit, smart missile. Which I wasn't sure about at first, and I... What was that? Come on, Shadow Fury. But yeah, since... as I was saying. Since tri-chording is a thing, using a gamepad is not a good idea. Darn it, why am I jumping into missiles? Okay. Get the smart missile. There we go. I know it's called Cerberus, but it's a smart missile by another name. And this is a fusion cannon by... Actually, this is kind of like a weird fusion cannon mass driver mix. But of course, it's a fusion cannon, which means aim down the hallway and shoot. Ah, shoot. Whoa, I can't turn? Sorry. Oh, that's why I'm hitting it. You know what? Forget it. I'm just going to use the mouse. This is... I'd rather not use the mouse, but it may just work better until I get a proper joystick. Which I may do now. I don't really want to... Well, I guess I can... It's 40 bucks. Not a big deal. Wait, I got the fusion cannon. And yes, I'm basically going to be using the old Descent names for a lot of things. Just because that's what I'm used to. And he's got the Mercury missiles. I have played through a bit of it, and I can't remember what... Oh, it's the 8th missile, the Atlas missile. It's a Mercury missile from Descent 2. It's very straightforwardly that. Brings back memories. Like, the fact that I was never very good at this game. Mind you, Descent was the sort of game where if you got, like... If you got one death... Or, sorry, one kill for every two deaths, that was playing well. So, I shouldn't feel too bad, but... Whoa, what the... Hang on a sec. This isn't team deathmatch, this is regular deathmatch. Why am I getting... Why am I getting a targeting reticle on the things I'm over? That's new. Let's see. So... Get behind. Oh, they got the ion cannon. The ion cannon is a new thing. It feels like a shock rifle from Unreal Tournament. More than it does anything out of Descent. And also, I apologize if it's a little bit difficult to see what's going on. Descent is like that. Or in this case, Sol Contingency, but yeah, it's like... Oh. I went straight forward. Wait, no, there's ion cannon right below me. But yeah, Descent's kind of like that. Stuff moves quickly. Where... Oh, right. Ion cannon, full energy. Let's get right behind them. Hey, I got a kill! I'm on the board! I guess a little bit more on the board, I should say. Why am I going near walls? I think one of the hardest things I've been finding about this is that there's no rearview mirror. Like, Descent had a rearview mirror as one of the things you could have. Because, well, you can move in all directions. I probably should have pointed that out. For anyone who's not familiar with Descent, gravity's not a thing here. At all. That's the cool thing about this game. Oh, that's why, because I'm using a seeker missile. Yeah, but gravity's not a thing here. Which means you actually don't want to be... Whoops. You don't want to be necessarily in front of or behind people. The best place to be is on top of people. But that's really hard. And it looks like... It's not super... Well, it's sort of obvious, I guess, but... Not everyone may be familiar with the way that Descent had its collision laid out, because it was a fairly old game, so its collision was purely sphere-based. It looks like Sol Contingency is going with that. I think Descent Underground, which is what Interplay is kind of doing as their reboot of Descent, which is weird. It was like... I remember 10 years ago, there was... Or 8 to 10 years ago, there were a bunch of attempts to reboot Descent that all kind of fell by the wayside. Like, you had Core Decision and into Cerberon, and then Core Decision became Geocore, and that I thought became Minor Wars, but apparently that it didn't. Apparently Minor Wars was something separate. So that's... And Geocore is apparently now a thing again, which is unexpected, but yeah. But anyway, with... Oh, right, I got the Mercury missiles, that's why. With Sol Contingency, that's something I actually heard of back then. This is a newer remake, and it's going somewhere. and then Descent Underground. It's like 2015s. All of a sudden, Descent remakes. They weren't a thing before, and now they're all of a sudden a thing, and I need that weapon. There we go. Oh, wait, no. There we go. Give me the Gatling. Sometimes it's worth just moving forward. Now I need to get better weapons. I don't have the choice of getting better weapons. Hello, enemy. That's Deathwinger. That was Deathwinger. Okay. Oh, shoot. What? I'm not dead. Okay, now I'm dead. Oh, they're using the dispersion gun. That's the one gun I haven't found yet. It's a shotgun, but I haven't found it yet. It's actually also rather new. So there's a couple weapons that are not things that were in Descent. Most of them were, some of them weren't. There's also these powers that I haven't quite figured out the effect of. This is the first multiplayer game I've played of Sol Contingency, by the way. But I thought I'd show it off, because it's awesome that I got into that the closed beta is a thing, I got into it, so. And since they said, feel free to make media off of it, I went, holy crap! Yes I will. Okay, so all things considered, mouse control isn't terrible. I mean, it's not mouse look, per se. But it handles okay. Like I said, it is a virtual joystick. And a joystick is recommended. Okay. But yeah, as far as virtual joysticks go, it's pretty typical. Deathbringer's right here. Come on. You know you have your Mercury missiles. Wow! I actually got the kill with that concussion missile? Sheesh. Or dumbfire missile, rather. Like I said, I'm going to be using Descent names. It's just what I'm used to. I will eventually learn the new names. I don't even know how permanent the names are going to be, though. I think that was the Cerberus missile. I almost said Smart missile. Didn't quite say it. Okay, so yeah, the tactic for using, well, in this case, the MAC, as it's called, but the Fusion Cannon is what it was called in the earlier games, is essentially to wait until it's fully, or charge it, keep charging it all the time, and then when you get into a hallway, fire it. Well, in this case, I actually can just see both my enemies at once. Ah, I got killed first. But yeah, the idea is you fire it down a hallway, and then if anyone's there, they get hit. Now, this weapon doesn't have quite the collision properties of the Fusion Cannon. The Fusion Cannon had, oops. I had no way of firing. The Fusion Cannon had a much wider hitbox. It was much, much wider. This is pretty much pinpoint. Whereas it's pinpoint against a sphere. But the Fusion Cannon was basically this hallway, a Fusion Cannon would hit anything inside it. And it would travel more slowly, too. It wasn't an instant fire thing. It would travel gradually, and then when it hit, it would pass through and continue hitting, but it was a slow-moving weapon. So you could fire down a hallway, forget about it, and then someone runs into the hallway and dies. Because they took a fusion shot to the face. The MAC isn't quite like that. As has become fairly obvious. Since I have been probably excessively using it. And hooray, I got the shotgun! I don't know how good this is. Unlike the Gatling, this doesn't really have an analogous weapon in Descent. It's interesting though, five shot and then it reloads, and I'm getting hit hard. Oh, shoot, they're behind me. Don't hit me! Wasn't a complete loss. But yeah, 9 to 15, that's not bad. Like, from a Descent perspective, the guy getting 20 to 9 is actually quite good. That's what Descent is like. Descent is a tough game. It's fun. I mean, this is not exactly Descent, as I mentioned before, but it's basically Descent. But yeah, Sol Contingency, very much like Descent, is rather difficult to get kills in. But also, actually, oh, I wanted to know, is this 20 shields? Ah, okay, this is not quite. Typically, one of the reasons why it was, so actually, saying 1 to 2 is not quite fair. I actually was playing below average. Because the way it worked in Descent, you could set the difficulty level for any multiplayer match, and that would change how much shields healed you. Most players played at most servers, rather, were set to the insane difficulty level, which gave you, I think, 12 shields every time you picked up a shield power-up. And you got one shield power-up every time you killed somebody. So basically, if you lost more than 12 shields off every kill, you would slowly, until you grabbed shield power-ups from the map, you would slowly but surely lose out to attrition. Which meant that if you were able to survive longer than one or two kills per every death or two, then you were actually doing quite well. But this is on 20 shields per power-up, which I think is equivalent to hotshot difficulty? Like the third difficulty or so, which isn't going to be quite the same. Oh crap, they have fusion cannon. I gotta get behind them. Or on top of them, either way. There we go. Okay, so that's working out. Yeah, with 20 shields per power-up, there's not much of an excuse to really go below 1 to 1. I'm not sure the exact math that you think. Apparently my opponent needs their joystick too. Well, that's understandable. That is the thing this game really does encourage. So yeah, the one thing I would say is that this game, you're going to want to get a joystick if you're going to want to play this. You don't necessarily have to. I mean, you can sort of play with the gamepad. It's just that, as I mentioned before, the gamepad does not handle... How much? Oh, wow, that uses 10. The gamepad doesn't work as effectively as... Well... as you'd think it would. Because on the one hand, movement is limited, rotation I should say, is limited. The mouse cannot rotate faster than a joystick could. But on the other hand, you can't really tri-chord with a pad. And while I'll have to do some additional testing, tri-chording does appear to be a thing, which means, well, not being able to do that is going to be a major Not being able to do that is going to be a major problem. Ah, did I miss again? Sheesh, this is getting hard. Okay, get out of here. I've got to get out of here. I'm not going to live. I'm on my way through. Where are the missiles? Ah, here's some missiles. Oh, crap, I'm out of energy. And they have a max shot charged. Just gotta get out of here and heal. Get energy. Wait, there's an energy replenishment station. Right along. There we go. Fueling station. Perfect. That's exactly what I need. One thing I have noticed is that Afterburner doesn't use up energy, which is really bizarre. Like, in all the Descent games, this is different from Sol Contingency, I guess. All the Descent games, when you had Afterburner, you ended up just... Basically, using Afterburner was free, but charging Afterburner took... charging Afterburner took energy. Yeah, Fusion's a lot easier to use than the Mac Cannon. Yeah, charging your Afterburner was the thing that took energy, but right now, no, it doesn't. It's just... it doesn't take anything. This is really strange. I find that odd. On. Alright, where is that? Nope. I want to experiment with this ion cannon a bit more. Oh, there they are. Hmm. effective, but very risky. There. I really like the animation on this. It's a very nice touch. Opening the whole thing up. That is really cool. Come on. Oops. Avoid the walls, boy. Okay. There we go. Oh, shoot. They got a smart missile going. That was very clever. Very well done. That I applaud that. Turbo's missiles are just as scary as the old smart missiles. That much is obvious. I kind of wish more people would come in here. This game is a good 1v1 game, but having multiple people is always cool. What I'm kind of curious about is, are the Sol Contingency devs going to bring back modes like Entropy? I don't know if they will or not. I'm not sure if I want them to or not. That was a weird mode. Not familiar, in Descent 3, there was a mode called Entropy where everyone had... it was two teams. Each team had various rooms. Some for energy recharge, some for shield recharge, some I think for ammo recharge that wasn't energy, and some with these little virus packs you could pick up. You'd only pick up a virus pack if you were on a 3-kill streak or more. Every 3 kills you got gave you some capacity for those virus packs. And every time you put 3 of those virus packs into a room, you captured it. So the point of the game was to get 3 kills in a row without dying, pick up one of those viruses, walk into an enemy room, repeat that 3 times, and do that for every single room they had. The actual rules of the game were pretty intense. Like, actually being able to pick up a virus, like getting enough kills to pick up a virus pack was very difficult. Because it was 3 kills to do it. And getting that was far from easy. It was a cool idea though. It's just one of those things where the rules could have been, like, no one really played it, possibly because it was almost impossible to actually get anywhere. Potentially the rules could be tweaked to make it less of a mode that requires you to play nearly perfectly. But it was kind of neat. I'm curious if they would actually, if the Sol Contingency team would be doing that. Or anything like it. I'm not sure what that power-up is. I think that purple power-up is Cloak, if I had to guess. Where is my opponent? This is why I want more people. They're around here somewhere. I think. Ah, there they are. So I'm gonna get my secret mountain. Oh shoot. I suck with the Mac Cannon. Oh, wow, I actually got a kill. Holy crap, I did not expect to get a kill there. I thought it was Hoop. Now give me those shields. I think this map is meant for a fairly large number of players, like 4 to 8 or something. That's weird. Like, strafe keys are a thing. Although maybe they mean because they're using a gamepad. Yeah, so they were talking about in Descent games, there was a mode, and instead of having keys for every particular slide motion, you could have a mode that would allow you to rotate. I should let them get away. Descent is a game of etiquette. But yeah, there was... I'm not kidding, Descent is a game of etiquette. Like, there is an etiquette to Descent. Spawn killing or chat killing is considered extremely taboo. Or at least was when I was playing. But yeah, with... It's a mess hall. There's nothing there, okay. Anyways, I was saying, so there was a key, instead of having hotkeys, right now I just have, like, RF for forward, backward, DG for left, right, YH for up, down, and then ET for banking. It's not WASD because I find it easier to press the buttons. Because you have secondary and primary weapons, I find it much easier to be able to press the buttons with my fingers at the center of the keyboard, rather than at the edge of the keyboard. But that's a... That ion cannon, I'm not used to that. But yeah, there was actually a way you could hit... I think it was not control, but there was hotkeys you could press that would change your rotation to strafing. Which I don't understand the reasoning for, since you pretty much want to be having all your strafing up all the time. Because like I said, tri-chording's a thing. I'm pretty sure it's a thing here. It was definitely a thing in earlier Descent games. You definitely got 1.7 times faster if you moved in all three axes at once. But, yeah, that's where I don't really understand what the point of having those hotkeys is. The strafe mode hotkeys, but whatever. Some people find that more comfortable. But that's the thing that probably should be addressed in feedback. And I don't see the point, but hey, if it helps someone out, then that's a thing that should be done. Especially since I'm not having much of a hard time with this, and that's... I feel bad. Like, it's... Clearly, it's because... clearly, it's partly because they are not playing in an optimal way for them. They don't have their joystick, they don't have their strafe keys, or a strafe toggle key. Yeah. So don't take this as a show of my own skill. I'm not playing especially well. Nope. No power-up down there. I still gotta figure out those power-ups, too. I feel like it was written somewhere. I looked at the manual that I got. I didn't see anything. Might be missing something. Don't want to go up. Okay, no one there. Nothing there. Where are they? Not down here. Alright, where are you? Oh, hey! Someone else is here! Awesome! I haven't played with before. Another thing this game doesn't have, which I don't personally care about all that much, but it's the thing that it doesn't have that early Descent did, is aligning to ground. If you notice, I'm upside down relative to the ground. I mean, it's Descent, there is no upside down. But if you look at the power-ups and you look at the terrain, I'm relative to that upside down. I mean, like I said, it's Descent. If you're thinking in terms of upside down or right side up, you're doing it wrong. But yeah. Wow, okay. But yeah, in earlier games it would align you to the nearest wall or nearest flat surface. Granted, in the earlier Descent games, it was actually cube-based. But even Descent 3, which was polygon-based, it did that. It aligned you to the nearest elementary axis, and that was kind of a neat little thing. Like I said, didn't really care about it, but it's a good thing for new players, because this game, when you can kind of just go upside down like this, and then you end up finding someone else... I mean, it's useless if you're playing seriously, because tri-chording, like I said, a lot of things... Tri-chording affects the fact that moving in all three directions at once gives you a 1.7 times like a root 3 speed boost affects a lot of the game's, not so much design, but definitely the way the UI is laid out, like what's useful and what's not. Toggle strafe is no longer useful, gamepads aren't really useful. The align to mines thing, actually the align to mine edge thing is not the most useful regardless. It does have limitations no matter what, but still. The fact is, when you're trying to move in all three directions at once, you're going to have a bit of a banking action going on if you want to do anything properly. Which means aligning to the ground... Oh, there they are. Aligning to the ground is a great way to get yourself killed. Or at least not killed, but you're going to be basically going... You're going to be rubbing against the wall as you move. And you don't want to do that. Ah. There we go, finally got a kill. Didn't lose too many shields either. Lost all my energy though. How much does Ion Oh, Ion Drain's 5 a shot, that's why. Okay, so I think the energy was... No. It's through here? Okay, it was through here and back here. Nice that they have fueling station written up. I'm trying to remember the exact layout of the level. Is not actually that hard? To be honest, it's actually a pretty navigable level, I think. But it helps having things like fueling station written there. Get to the main courtyard. Okay, whatever this power-up is, I still don't know. I still think it's cloak. I know this... Oh, right, that's what I wanted to go find. If you go up... Or, I guess, up through one of the roof ceiling hatches. No, it's not cloaking. I can... Or... Oh, it is cloaking. Huh. Okay, well, that mystery's solved. Purple is cloaking. Good to know. Also, I'm so glad they brought in reflective surfaces. I realize that's a thing Unreligion can just do with very little cost, but it was one of those cool things that Descent had, was reflective surfaces. For, okay, I'm kind of gushing nostalgic because that's one of those... Back in 1995, 96, 99, Descent 2, 1, 2, and 3, or I think 2 might have been 97. Like, you know, back in the mid to late 90s when Descent games were actually out, it was super cool. Oh, I'm being vain. I'm dying. Vanity is killing me. But yeah, back in the mid-90s, it was a super awesome thing to have. Now, of course, it's nothing special, and it's just it's kind of cool, but... reflections are have a nice touch to them, but... Yeah, back in the mid-90s... Holy crap, that was awesome. Like, this... Descent was a looker in its time. I'm just kind of glad they threw that in there. It's a nice touch. It also means I could figure out what the heck that purple power-up was. Because, as I thought, it wasn't decloaking. Now, the other one, it must be some sort of super shield or something like that? Where did I find it? I found it down one hall. There's a hall... Some hall or another that I found it down. Ah, they're cloaked. Although, I'm not going to shoot yet. Another piece of Descent etiquette from back in the day. If someone... Isn't shooting... Okay, it's not quite using that, but like... If you notice that someone spawned or is using blue lasers and concussion missiles... Well, blue lasers and concussion missiles, if they're using that on you, they want to fight. But basically, if they're... If they've just spawned, don't hit them. Because they don't just have the lasers and concussion missiles or laser and dumbfire missiles this time around. Where are the weapon power-ups? All being taken from me. Yeah, you let them go. If they fight you, however, no, you don't. You fight. But yeah, it's on their terms, basically. If someone spawns, you fight them on their terms. And... The last piece will be relevant when I end the stream is that... Oh boy, this is actually risky. Ah, I got away with it. Yes! But yeah, the last piece of etiquette, which is going to be relevant when I end, is... Don't end on a death. End on a kill. Someone went through here. I'm asking to find them.
1 minute remains.
Oh.
10 kills remain.
Well, I'm not winning, that's for sure. Oh, shoot. Ah, they went past me. Although, if the game ends, I suppose that's fine, too. There's only 40 seconds left. But yeah, if you're leaving halfway through, it was the done thing to leave once you'd gone to kill. You get a kill, and then you leave. Rather than rage quitting because you left on a death. Because it reads as rage quitting, basically. And for wondering, that was the reason why in my earlier Skullgirl streams, I would get annoyed when I didn't win, and it was like, I need to win before I leave. That was etiquette I learned from Descent, which doesn't apparently apply to fighting games, but whatever. It does apply to Sol Contingency, probably, because basically the same game.
You have lost the match.
One to one. I guess a 1-to-1 when it was not very many people. So I could probably just do one more game because it'll switch over to another map. Ah, this will work better for the number of players we have. Okay. I don't remember exactly how this map is laid out, though. Did they see me? They did. Although, actually, when I say blue lasers, that's actually... I suppose it's a bit different, because this game doesn't have super laser or quad laser. It does, however, have laser fire mode. Which I'm not really sure what I think about. I haven't really used it too much. But yeah, you start out with quad laser, and there's no super laser. Like, super form of your laser, which was a thing. Actually, in earlier Descent games, there were 6 levels to your laser. Descent 3 reduced it to 2. You gonna come after me? Are ya? No. Actually, one thing that'd be nice, given the amount of space that they have in the UI, would be to have a little count of how many missiles you have of each type. Not just the one that's currently active. Because I think I have 4 secret missiles? Yes, I do. Hey, I'm getting the new names! Okay. Come on, come on, just drop already! Okay, I'm getting chased, someone behind me. I have much to learn. Like I said before, my performance in that last game is not at all indicative of my actual skill. I was playing someone who was severely disadvantaged, and that showed. Oh. Ah, shoot. Man, Shelly's pretty good at the Mac aiming. Remarkably good at the Mac aiming, in fact. Okay, let's see. Are you... Yeah! Smart missile actually worked. Or Cerberus missile. It basically is a smart missile, used the same way. Although, actually, the best way, I believe, was to fire it behind the enemy. But firing at your feet is also a good idea. So you fire it at your feet, and then all of a sudden they got smart missile stuff shooting at them, they don't know exactly where it's coming from. Well, this actually might work okay for the Mac, another thing about it. Oh, I got a cloak. That'll be handy. Ah, well, at least something worked. Well, energy. There we go. And let's get the power up. Oh, that's not the power up, that's just shields. This is very different. Compared to the fusion cannon. Crap. Crap. The energy. Wow, they smart missiled me. That was close. Did not realize this would happen. missed. I got one more shot of this. And I messed it up. Wow. Ow. Yeah, no! Shoot. Ah, that was painful. And that was the person who was at the top of the board, too. Ah. Got a bit of room. What? I just picked it up, didn't I? Or is that more dumbfire? I think it was more dumbfire. Okay, well, where are my opponents? There's enough of them. Man, not having rear view is so tricky. It's one of the things that mitigated the fact that you couldn't turn very quickly, is that, I mean, you can't, apparently they can't do it on Religion 3. Some stuff to do with the way the scale form works means that they can't actually do that. But yeah, it was a thing you could do in Descent, and which apparently will be available once they get the Unreal Engine 4 version of this done, or started up. Because it is using Unreal Engine 3, but it will be using Unreal Engine 4. And Unreal Engine 4 allows you to take scenes from the game and put them on and draw them onto the UI, which you can't do in Unreal Engine 3. Or if you can, it's some weird hack. But yeah, normally you can't. Apparently. Once that's available, then rear view will be a thing, and rear view's one of the things that really mitigates not being able to turn around, because then you can see what's behind you. You can't see what's beside you, above you, or below you, so there's still a lot of threats that can come at you. But at least you can see what's behind you. Okay, I'm going through the circuit wrong. I like this level design, though. I like the use of the curved tunnels. Ah, oh, I didn't get the kill. Didn't get any kill. There's no... They're not dead yet. Where'd they go? Oh, crap. Get into an open air. Wow. I won that fight? That was such a scrum there. I didn't expect to win that. That was one of those situations where if you have the shields and ammo, you win. Otherwise, you... Oh, shoot. I just noticed, it doesn't drop your equipped weapons. Or just, I don't think it does. I'm gonna point that out. Not sure if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but yeah, it used to be... Well, okay, I should say, once again, in Descent, if you dropped... Aw, didn't get hit by the smart missiles. Or if they did, that didn't do much. Oh, they had the super shield power-up, or whatever that is. Shoot. But yeah, in Descent... What was I saying? It was the... Oh, right, yeah. You, whenever you died, whatever weapons you had equipped... In earlier games, it was whatever weapons you had on your ship. In Descent 3, it was just the ones that were equipped would drop, and you'd... And enemies could pick them up. So it really encouraged using your weapons when you had them. Rather than equipping something and then not using it. Not sure if that's really necessary given that additional weapons gives you additional firepower, but it was a thing. Oh, come on. Where'd they go? It also meant that you could get a lot of concussion missiles. Because it was pretty tempting to not use them since they didn't home or have any other special properties. But hey, damage is damage. And it's also, your opponent doesn't get them. Ah, finally got kill on the oh, they're not at the top of the board. I'm still surprised that Afterburner doesn't require energy. That's just... That weirds me out. Ah, nope. Now, I wonder if for levels like this, they're going to do a varicose vein style setup where you have some sort of one-way passage. Okay, admittedly, varicose veins was a hack that involved basically abusing the way that everything is one-sided, because 3D graphics are all one-sided, but still. I'm curious if that's ever going to be a thing where... no!
One kill remains.
Where people have start locations that are protected. Because that was a thing back in... well... that was a thing with one particular Descent 3 level. It's called Varicose Veins. It's a popular CTF... the CTF level, pretty much. Super popular level. Shoot, I killed myself. Tricky weapon. Anyway, yeah, it was the CTF level. Kind of still is. I mean, the game's pretty dead, but... if you're going to see it played, it'll probably be on Varicose Veins. Yeah, that was... that was the map. And that map had... ah! I was not killed, but yeah, that was the map. And that had one-way spawn points. You start off in an area, and then you walk through, essentially, a wall, and then that meant that you were protected when you spawned. Not sure what's going to happen here. That'd be kind of neat if it did. But anyway, that was Sol Contingency. I want to play more of this. I probably will end up streaming more of it. I'm not sure if I'll stream this beta version. I might stream as the beta version's update. Or the real game starts up in the Unreal Engine 4 version. But yeah, this is fun. So the beta's still closed. It'll become open sometime in the week of November 10th, I think. And then it, after that, we'll then be focusing on the Unreal Engine 4 version. So, once again, I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you for watching. And check this out when it's more openly available. Or if you can get into it, because I think they might still be accepting people. Yeah, check it out. So, thanks again for watching, and have a good night, everyone.